For 2023, Mini's doing the right thing for the John Cooper Works hot hatch. They've been able to find some manual gearboxes to put in these things. This one's got a 6-speed. What's it like? Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. And if anything, I've got a lot of race experience driving front-wheel drive cars, so I've got a real thing for hot hatches. Now, this 23 Mini John Cooper Works is an interesting thing because they have brought back the manual transmission, and that is a very cool thing for enthusiasts like us. But before we get into what's it like to drive, let's have a look at this Mini John Cooper Works in a little more depth. It goes without saying that this is not exactly a Mini of old for today's standards. It is a small car, but it is still kind of relatively big to be called a Mini. Nonetheless, it is absolutely a hot hatch and it's doing all the right things. Under the hood is a 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder, 228 horsepower at 5,200 RPM and peak torque of 235 pounds at 1,450 RPM. That's just incredible. Gearbox is, of course, a 6-speed manual. Suspension is McPherson struts in the front, multi-link at the rear. Suspension settings are specific to the John Cooper Works and adaptive dampers are apparently optional. Front brakes are by Brembo. Wheels and tires are either 17s or 18s. Your only tire choices are run flats, of course. And in terms of curb weight, this isn't exactly Mini. This tips the scales right around 3,000 pounds. Sorry for this brief interruption, but I want the opinion of regular viewers of the show. I'm now co-hosting a radio show Saturday mornings in Toronto. It's called Dave's Corner Garage. Go to davescornergarage.com. Links here, links below, and listen in on Saturdays. Podcast episodes are on the website as well, and I'd love to know what you think. So go to davescornergarage.com. Listen in Saturday mornings, 10 a.m. in Toronto. All the details are there, and let me know what you think in the comments below. Much appreciated. Thank you. The basic cockpit here is absolutely spot on. You've got a highly adjustable and supportive seat, lots of adjustment in the steering column. And I think for the first time, I actually don't have a steering column fully extended in my direction, just so I can interface the pedals a little bit better, which we'll talk about in a second. But otherwise, this interior is completely Mini. So you've got all of the controls that you would expect, but they're organized in Mini's very unique way. So for example, toggle switches, you got a toggle switch for the stop start function. And of course, this controller works very similar to that you would find in a BMW, for example, but it's down here and sort of finished in a Mini style and controls the infotainment system again, which works in very much a BMW way, but just styled to look like it belongs in a Mini. Works very effectively, and of course, it's got Apple CarPlay. With respect to instrumentation, it's very much Mini as well. So you've got a little digital instrument cluster here right in front of you, very easy to read. And then there is a little heads-up display that pops up on top of the dash. It's almost redundant because this instrument cluster is so easy to see, easy to read, that you kind of don't need the heads-up display. But, you know, it's a cool feature. Some people may like it. I don't really care for it. What I do appreciate about this driver interface is the way that the pedals are laid out. No problem with heel and toe at all. And if you don't know how to heel and toe, check here, check in the description below for our ultimate guide to heel and toe, and I'll teach you how to do that. Nonetheless, pedals are laid out wonderfully. No problem with heel and toe with my skate shoes. Probably a narrower shoe would be a little bit compromised. And the shift lever is easily within reach, though it does seem like it's on an extra tall shift lever here, but otherwise it's just fine. The feel of this is fairly light, but there is a way to drive this Mini John Cooper Works that I find to be more effective than others, as we will get into in a little bit. In terms of spaciousness, no problem for you and your right seat passenger. I wouldn't put anybody, any humans, in that back seat except for tiny, tiny children, maybe small animals, but it's kind of unusable for adults. There's no question about that. Under the hatch, well, that's limited as well. Thankfully, the rear seats split fold and you can use all of this space for your stuff. But right now, under the hatch, all I've got is my carry-on size camera bag and a tripod, and that's about all that's going to fit there. Sure, you can get a little more innovative and then, of course, fold down the seats, but otherwise there's not a lot of room under that hatch. In terms of visibility, it's quite excellent, at least from where I'm sitting. I can see all around, big mirrors as well, and great visibility out the rear. Can't fault this Mini for that. So let's try this from a stop. Very little torque steer here at all. I think the tires do like to follow the grooves in the road, but otherwise no problem putting down power, although power output in first gear seems to be a little bit reduced, even in sport mode, and that's probably a good thing. If you want to take care of your car, it's way too easy to abuse the front axle in a front-wheel drive hot hatch, that's for sure. But the way they've tuned this, very easy to drive. And again, no problem putting down power. Couldn't find any technical details as to what kind of differential is in here, and I haven't driven it in any slippery conditions, so really haven't explored what's going on. But I think what's going on in there is there's an open diff as well as some pretty dialed suspension geometry so that it minimizes any torque steer. What is incredible with this John Cooper Works is the amount of torque that this engine makes, especially from low RPM, like 1400 RPM peak torque is available. So you really don't have to spend a lot of time shifting this gearbox. There's no question about that. But what I do enjoy is really wringing this thing out. It's way more enjoyable when you drive it properly, when you really take it by the scruff of its neck and hustle this thing. It really doesn't like to be driven slowly or lazily. It's not very enjoyable that way. But when you really get on it and are on top of the car, it's absolutely satisfying, and it's like it was designed to be driven like that. Perhaps the only part of the driving experience to complain about is the shifter. There's not a lot of feel here. The gates aren't that well defined. The shift action is very, very light, but I haven't missed any shifts. And also, I would say that the detente for reverse is not that strong. So if you're parking, you're going to occasionally get reverse instead of first gear, but you'll get used to that as you spend more time with this. Otherwise, love the way that I can get on top of this Mini John Cooper Works. And the thing about this engine, the way that it makes power, it's got that very low torque peak and a very high power peak. It's like you're always in the right part of the rev range. This thing is deceptively quick. When you're on the move, the thing is that this is much quicker than it actually feels. Oh, and while we're heel and toeing here, the one thing that this John Cooper Works doesn't have is rev matching. So you got to do heel and toe downshifts yourself. That's the right way to do it. The steering has a modest amount of feel, and the amount of assist seems to depend on the drive mode that you've selected. Here in sport mode, it's got a little less assist, so it feels a little firmer, but it's just got a modest amount of feel. I think most of the feel in this John Cooper Works Mini comes through the chassis more than anything else. Steering is quick enough to be enjoyable, absolutely, even near this Mini's limits. It's just fine in terms of controlling the attitude of this Mini, and because it's really not that big of a car, you can really stay on top of it as well. Braking is fantastic, and I think part of it has to do with the fact that there are some Brembo calipers on the front. For a hot hatch, brake pedal effort is spot on. It is on the lighter side of things, but feel is just wonderful. Modulation and power absolutely spot on as well. Very, very happy with this brake pedal. And, you know, of course, I love driving cars on their brake pedals every once in a while when you're hustling hot hatches like this. The suspension is definitely tuned for handling over ride comfort. So we have crappy roads in this part of the world. There's no question about that. So there's a lot of road noise and a little bit of crash through that comes through here. And then every once in a while, when you hit a bigger road imperfection, there's some body movement that just is inherent in the suspension setup. But I'd rather have it like this in a John Cooper Works than this being any softer. And the thing is, even though it is on the firmer side, it still does permit a bit of body roll. So this Mini is very much communicating with you while you're on the move, as it should. That's what a hot hatch should be doing. But it is on the heavier side, so there is a bit more body roll than I would like. They could button that down, but of course, if you do that, then you're going to compromise your overall ride quality, which isn't the best thing to do, especially when you're dealing with a car that's meant to be driven on public roads and enjoyed daily. You don't want something that's too firmly suspended, that's for sure. Overall balance, however, is on the neutral side. It's definitely not loose and it doesn't understeer by itself. No, this thing is not tuned to understeer. There's only one thing that makes a car understeer, and it is the nut behind the wheel, but that's another story for another day. Like I was saying earlier, what makes this John Cooper Works is the way you drive it. When you're really on top of the car and really getting on it, being very deliberate about your gear choice, your throttle application, your brakes, your steering, it's so satisfying to drive, and it's the way this thing should be driven. It is a hot hatch. It does say John Cooper Works, so I guess it kind of makes sense, but you really need to be on top of this car to get the most out of it, to get the most driving satisfaction, that's for sure. As we're driving along here in a little bit of the suburbs, driving it slowly and lazily is really not that much fun, but when you ring it out, run this thing to redline, and pull off a quick shift, it's absolutely a blast to drive. And in the corners, it's so much fun. And what's more, it's even thrilling when you're pulling out of corners. This thing just does exactly what you want it to do from an overall dynamic package standpoint. This thing is just so much fun to throw around in the corners as well. Sure, I'd like a better performance-oriented tire than what's on here and really don't like run flats, but this thing as a package just works so well. And I love getting on the gas, exiting corners. So much fun. How do you spec yours? Well, it's fairly easy. What you are looking at is Rebel Green with the red roof, red mirrors, and some stripes on it. Not sure if this is my aesthetic. This one also rolls on 17s, and have I told you how much I hate black wheels? But the thing is, with the Mini John Cooper Works, there really aren't any performance-specific options. It's basically features and colors. That is about it. But what you do need, of course, is that manual transmission. And if you are looking for a highly contented, quick hot hatch, well, this is one hot hatch that should be on your list. My verdict, well, one of the things this does well is actually sip fuel. I think I'm getting around 25 miles per gallon or a little under 10 liters per 100 kilometers for my Canadian friends, and I'm just driving it like I love it. So no problem getting decent fuel consumption numbers in this Mini John Cooper Works. As for the rest of the car, no question, it's a hot hatch, but it is very highly contented. Yes, it is on the pricey side. Don't really care for some of the sound augmentation that they do. I'd like a little bit more of an exhaust note here, a little bit more of an attitude. And speaking of which, sure, it's mini in size, but it is mega in terms of attitude. I just love this thing, especially when you drive it properly. When you really grab a hold of this John Cooper Works, it's absolutely rewarding to drive and certainly deceivingly quick. There's no question about that. And what I love about the Mini is that it seems exceptionally well screwed together, and it's got all the content I could ever want in a hot hatch. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2023 Mini John Cooper Works. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube. You know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring, so please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel and our cause, is please hit up the merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even minis that say John Cooper works.